Correspondents, I've never been to the correspondents dinner. And I'm on the Hill today and tomorrow, fighting for arts in education, for the NEA, for just in general, the governmental support of the arts. I think it's awful. I understand why it's gotten cut, because quite often, you know, in times of dire need, you've got to find your money elsewhere, and so it gets cut. I'm not happy about it. I've got kids in school. What we're asking for, although it's a lot of money to you, to me, in the scheme of things, it's a drop in the bucket. It's nothing. The effect it has is tremendous. Tremendous what the NEA does. They just make a contribution to whatever theater company, to an artist, whatever. It generates, it's like a ripple in the water. It just goes outward so much. I was supposed to go to law school. Acting was something I always wanted to do. It didn't hurt to defer for a year or two. So I tried acting and I was lucky.
We heard that. So you played on Spin City, you played as press secretary. Have you had a chance to interact with people who actually take on that role here in D.C.?
You mean, take on a role? They are. It's not. Not this trip. I have met President Bush's press secretary. I've met quite a few in the days. I've even had people stop me on the street and say, I am the press secretary of, or was, of my town. And so I certainly know.
I heard, and I want you to tell me, I heard that George Clooney was the best man at your wedding.
Yeah, but I don't talk a lot about George because he gets enough publicity himself. There's no reason to, and he doesn't want that much. There's no reason for me to keep adding logs to the fire.
Sure, yeah. No, we're big fans of his.
Oh, he's a great guy. I'll talk about, he's a magnificent man.
Yeah. What would you recommend to people when you say, how should we change this view of the arts? And, you know, why is this something to change the...
Okay, I'll tell you why. It's because I think when people think of the arts, they think of it as a frivolous thing. It's sort of ephemeral. Hey, I really like that concert. Oh, I like the dance. They have found that not only does it let children do better in school, improve their grades, for a lot of underprivileged kids, it keeps them in school. Therefore, keeps them out of jail, keeps them off the streets, keeps them out of trouble. They have found that for every dollar that the NEA spends, it gets returned times seven. For instance, if a troupe comes to town, you're dealing with restaurants, hotels, dry cleaning, kids being assistant, being drivers, taxis. It's like I said, it's a ripple effect. So spending money on the arts is not the end all. So it has an economic effect that you don't even think about. First of all, Carol's the nicest person in the world, which I'm not going to say Larry David isn't very nice, but Carol Burnett is the nicest person in the world. Very giving, very collaborative. There's nobody greater than Carol. There's a reason why America loves her, because she deserves to be loved. Larry and I get along great. He's a very moral guy. You know, he portrays a pain in the neck, but he's not. He's a good guy. He and I go golfing a lot, or sometimes together, but most often not together. We had that in common, and therefore there was something that we were able to talk about. But both are truly worthy of their fame and their success. They are both masters at what they do, as is Mike Fox, Michael Fox, who was also a master and a great guy.
Is there anyone you're looking forward to seeing while you're in town here, either a Washington personality or someone you're hoping to bump into at the dinner?
A guy named Rocco Landisman, who produced the Broadway play The Producers, which I did for about 8 months on Broadway. And Rocco was head of the NEA, and I want to see him. We also have mutual friends. I happen to like him. I love his wife, and I want to say hi to him. I haven't seen him in a while. And he was a big horse racing fan, and I was on the show Luck, and I wanted to find out how he likes Luck.